Hi. In this video, we take a look at a basic workflow for sending automated emails within SharePoint Online. We imagine that our SharePoint Online site has a daily reports library that contains, unsurprisingly, daily reports. Our workflow will create a new, unique report file and mail a link to access the report to selected recipients. This automation cannot be modeled using the default activities in SharePoint Online, so we will use HarePoint Workflow Extensions for Office 365. Let's start in SharePoint Designer and add a new list workflow for the Daily Reports library. We configure our workflow to launch every time a new item is created. To better explain the workflow, we will split it into two stages. First, the document part. This part will prepare the report file to be sent by giving it a unique file name using the username and the upload date. Second, sending email. This part of the workflow sets the email server properties and sends the email message containing the link to the file in the SharePoint library. To keep our file names unique, we rename each one using the upload time. Colons and slashes that are used in the date format are not allowed in the file name, so we will convert them into something that can be used as a proper file name. Let's add the convert date to text action from the date time group. With this, we specify the file creation date. Let's set the mask for the date format and save it to the text date variable. Next, we rename the report file. We use the rename document at URL action from the document library group. We will point to the current report file's absolute encoded URL and specify the new file name, where we will use the file creator display name and the date from the variable text date. That should do it for now. Let's move to the email part. For a workflow to send email, it needs to connect and authorize on the mail server. For these two actions, we will need the set authentication from the workflow group and the set SMTP server options action from the email group. Let's add set authentication and choose our authorization type for the email server. To get an encrypted token, we open the HarePoint Workflow Extension app and go to the security page in its settings. Here, we need to specify the login and password in order to generate a security token. Then, we copy the token and use it in our workflow. Next, we set the connection to the mail server. We use the set SMTP server options action from the email group. Here, we specify the server we connect to. That should be it for the connection. Now let's look at the email itself. We use the send email without attachment action from the email group. Specify our recipient in the to field and use the report's author as the subject of the email, using the create by in display mode. In the body of the email, we put in the report creation date using the short date. And add an encoded absolute URL to the report itself. SharePoint will show this as a link. Please note that if we add ?web=1, to the URL, it will be opened in the browser, in this example, Internet Explorer. Lastly, we specify the sender in the From field. And that's it. Now we can publish our workflow and test it. Let's open our report library and upload a test report. The workflow starts as soon as the upload is complete. We see that the file name was changed. It is now the author's name and the upload date. We can check the workflow logs to see that all the steps were completed successfully and without issues. Our recipient has received a new email with the uploaded data in the email's body and subject. If we use the link provided, it opens to an Excel online report. And that concludes our video. That was a basic example of what can be achieved with the help of additional actions provided by HarePoint Workflow Solutions, which can help you create complex and flexible workflows without coding or in-depth configuration. Feel free to download a 30-day trial of the product or contact us for a personal demo session.